Hi there. Look at this magnificent brioche tête. But it's not. There is so much going on in this tart. It's unbelievable. I mean, if you like chocolate, coffee, and caramel, it's just out of this planet. Hey, I am Bruno Albouz. You are watching The Real Deal Cooking Channel. Let the baking begin. First, the chocolate crust, sugar dough or pâte sucrée, cream, butter and salt. Throw in sugar, cocoa powder and almond meal. Drop in the egg and then the flour. Wrap up and chill. For this recipe, I'm gonna use a brioche à tête fluted mold, though any tart pan works. But in that one, it just looks phenomenal. So, cut out a third of the chilled pastry, work it out to soften, and roll out into a 5mm, 0.20-inch thick disc. Lay over the chilled mold and carefully pat the dough down, following the pattern of the mold. Chill for a little bit and remove excess dough. Lightly prick and freeze until ready to bake. For this specific application though, you want the crust to end up being a little bit thicker than usual. Indeed, if too thin, it could break. Bake at 350 degrees Fahrenheit, 180 Celsius, for 20 minutes. Then egg wash using a mixture of an egg, heavy cream, and cocoa powder. Pop in the oven for 5 minutes, then remove the brioche mold. Egg wash the inside and bake again. Next. Flourless chocolate biscuit. On y va les petits lapins. Beat egg whites to stiff peaks, adding sugar gradually, then lower the speed, drop in the egg yolks, then incorporate the melted chocolate and butter. That's it. Pipe out into disc and bake for 20 minutes. Look at this cute escargot. Next in the agenda, we are going to make a luscious caramel chocolaté sauce. Make a browned caramel first with the corn syrup and sugar. Lower the heat and carefully pour the hot cream mixture. Cook caramel mixture to 230 degrees Fahrenheit, 110 degrees Celsius. Add the salt and the chocolate. Transfer to a pastry bowl to cool down a bit, then get your bazooka ready. Throw in butter and give a great emulsion. For a more gooey finish, add more milk. For the full recipe, check out my website at brunoalbouz.com. Now, we're gonna make an incredible chocolate coffee creamer. Heat up espresso with heavy cream to 122 Fahrenheit, 50 degrees Celsius. Add egg yolks and blend well. We are making a crème anglaise. Now you will cook it to 185 Fahrenheit, 85 degrees Celsius. And then I'm gonna sieve it over the chocolate. Let it sit, blend it, chill, done deal. Gorgeous. No question about it. There is a lot going on in this dessert. It's definitely worth it. Next, the coffee marmalade. This thing is a game changer. Heat up espresso or water and instant coffee and swirl in sugar and agar-agar mixture. Bring to a boil and cook for a minute. And then let's set completely in a refrigerator and blend. And the secret weapon? Lemon zest. You'll be surprised how much a little bit of lemon zest enhances the flavor of the coffee. It's quite amazing. The last thing is gonna be our vanilla mascarpone chantilly. We're gonna actually make a ganache monté. Mix half of the hot heavy cream with the vanilla and some white chocolate. Add remaining chilled heavy cream, mascarpone, blend well, and refrigerate overnight. Then whip it to medium firm peaks. Of course. This is just not even too sweet. It's perfectly flavored. So in order to mimic the brioche à tête bump, I'm gonna fill up 2 half spheres of chantilly and freeze. Are you ready to build that awesome dessert? Let's do it. The first layer, it's gonna be the chocolate coffee creamer. Then add a flourless chocolate biscuit, the caramel chocolaté sauce, another chocolate biscuit, more chocolate coffee creamer, creating a space in which you're gonna pour some of the coffee marmalade. Add the last chocolate biscuit, more caramel chocolate sauce, and the vanilla mascarpone chantilly. Ooh la la, that's gonna be something, I'm telling you. A lot of work, but hey, no pain, no gain. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you have enjoyed this one-of-a-kind mochaccino tart. To know everything about this incredible recipe and much more, go to my beautiful website and tell me about it, brunoalbouz.com. Please subscribe, like my page on Facebook, and by the way, try this recipe out and tag me on Instagram at brunoalbouz. Also, to get some of my merch, t-shirt, coffee cup, and much more, check that out down below.
Wow.
Bon appetit, buon appetito, ciao ciao.